Hey Dream Chasers, it's JC, and today I'm going to talk about how to design a sub badge for Twitch. So last year I did a video about how to design emotes for Twitch, and recently I did a follow-up to that to answer frequently asked questions. But one of the most commonly asked questions that I get is, how do you design sub badges? Sub badges are similar to emotes, so a lot of the same things will apply, but they are a little bit different, namely that they're much smaller, which makes them harder to design. If you don't know what sub badges are, they're the little icon that appear next to subscribers in Twitch chat. They used to only be available for partner streamers, but recently Twitch made them available for affiliates. Depending on how long someone's been subscribed, the badge will change. So there's a 1 month, 3 months, 6 month. They recently added a 9 month icon and 1 year. And when you're a partner, you can unlock 2 years, 3 years, etc. So I'm going to cover how to design sub badges in this video, but if you're not sure you're up to the task or you're not that artistic, you can hire an artist to design them for you. I sometimes take commissions, but they're not always open. So if you're thinking of hiring me, please do me a favor and check my Twitter page or my Twitch page to see if commissions are currently open and shoot me a message. If they're not open or you want to hire someone else, you can check out Fiverr. Fiverr recently opened up a Twitch store where you can hire artists to design your emotes, sub badges, panel graphics, overlay graphics, or anything you need for Twitch. And so if you want to find someone who can do all that stuff for you, check the link in the description. Full disclosure, this video is not officially sponsored by Fiverr, but I do get money if you sign up through that link. Anyway, if you do want to give it a shot yourself, here are my tips on how to design a sub badge. So the biggest difference between an emote and a sub badge is the size. Just like emotes, you need to upload 3 file sizes for sub badges. The sizes are 72 by 72 pixels, 36 by 36, and 18 by 18. That's tiny. I recommend when you are designing your sub badges to actually start at 200 by 200 and then shrink it down. That way you have enough room to draw everything and get all your detail in there, but you're not working in such a large size that you end up putting way more detail than you need. And my first piece of advice is to keep it simple. I wouldn't get complicated with these. If you're drawing a character or a channel mascot, I would try to pick a really simple straight on pose for the head. Don't try to include a lot of details like shoulders and body, just a face looking straight on or maybe a little bit to the side. Keep it very simple. Don't go crazy with expressions because that small, it's really hard to get that to read. I would also avoid a lot of extra shading and details. And just like emotes, I would think of sub badges as more of a design than an illustration. So you want to get the idea of something across. It's an icon. It's not going to be a full finished drawing, and a lot of times less is more. To that point, I think that pixel art works really well as a sub badge because pixel art is designed to be really, really small, but to be recognizable as whatever object it is. The streamer Spooky Draws has a really cute pixel mug emote that illustrates this point very well. Of course, there are exceptions to this. JL Draco, another creative streamer on Twitch, has really detailed sub badges. The first one that you get for just being a subscriber for 1 month is a dragon egg, which has a lot of detail in the scales, and then it hatches over time and becomes a full dragon. So after a year of being a sub, you have a full dragon portrait. And these sub badges are very detailed, but I think the reason they work so well is because the colors and the shapes are all really recognizable. It's clear that you're looking at a dragon, even if you can't see every single little detail. And I think because JL has a lot of design and illustration experience, that's why he was able to pull that off. Your line work is really important in a sub badge. Just like I mentioned in the emote video, I prefer colored lines for sub badges and emotes. The reason is when you shrink down any graphic to really small, all the pixels kind of merge together and it's not as clean and clear as when you designed it at a larger size. And so a lot of times when you use black line work, it just becomes this kind of muddy mess and it's really hard to tell what all the different shapes and parts of your drawing are. If you use colored line work that's similar to the color you're using to color everything in, but maybe a little bit darker, I think that just usually reads a lot better. Using colored line work helps you separate everything so you can really tell what's going on. Color and value are really important when designing a sub badge. I would recommend keeping your color palette limited to just a few colors because if you get it really full of color and it's elaborate, it's going to be kind of hard to read and it's going to be muddy when you shrink it down. I would also recommend that you make sure you have a decent use of contrast in your work. If you're shrinking it down and you kind of can't tell what everything is, chances are your colors are too close together and your values are too close together, meaning your lights and your darks. If you're finding that, say, a mouth on your character is blending in with the rest of the face, maybe try making the mouth a little bit darker than the skin on the face. Stuff like that will really help make your emotes and your sub badges pop. Some people like to do text for their sub badges, but personally, I think it's very difficult to pull off and have it read well. If you have a logo or something that's one or two letters, you might be able to pull off text, but anything bigger than that, it kind of doesn't work. You can't really read it, so I kind of would stay away from that. And if you have a logo, you might want to use that as your sub badge. But just keep in mind that not every logo is going to shrink down and look really good or read well, so it's going to depend on what your logo looks like. One of my favorite examples of a logo as a sub badge is by the creative streamer Stevie Ray Drawn. Stevie has a really simple outline of a bull's head, and it's just a single color with a gradient and some highlights, and it changes color at each level of subscription, and it's instantly recognizable, and it looks really professional. Ideally, if you're gonna use a logo, it should be something really simple and bold like what Stevie has. But Stevie's sub badges don't just work because they're simple. A big part of why they work is because they have a really strong silhouette. Case in point, Kale McDonald's sub badges are a lot more detailed, but they still read really well. The reason for that is they have very strong shapes that read well. The 1 month badge is basically a circle with a big V in the center, and the other details are in there, but those shapes read well even at that size. And Kale's 1 year design also has a lot of small details and lines, but the overall shape of a coyote head makes it really strong. It's easy to tell what it is just by glancing at it. And lastly, I think one of the things people struggle with sub badges is coming up with a concept. And I would say, don't overthink it too much. Just have fun with it. There's really no right or wrong way to do a sub badge. Do you like coffee? Make a coffee sub badge. Do you have a pet? Make your pet your channel mascot and use them as a sub badge. Some streamers use their face in different colors. There's really no wrong answer here. Just have fun and make it your own. And then finally, if you want to test your sub badge design, there's a website that I recommend that makes it really easy to test emotes and badges. I use the Twitch contrast tool at twitch-contrast.firebaseapp.com. The top box is for uploading emotes, but there's a smaller box underneath, and that's to test your sub badges. The site makes it really easy to see what your sub badges will look like in chat in either dark or light mode. Ew, who's using light mode? Anyway, that's my advice for designing Twitch sub badges. I hope it was helpful. If you're interested in learning how to design emotes, I've made a few videos about that in the past. There's links in the description. I also have a link to that contrast tool where you can test your emotes, and a link to Fiverr if you want to hire someone to design emote for you. Anyway, that's it for me. Until next time, chase your dreams. Peace.